Hey, sexy people of the most mysterious interwebs. Well, we have quite a day here. Quite a day. It's been quite a day. Now, this driver tech might go off while we're speaking, as we're going back and forth with messages right now, and I'll fill you in on what that's all about. But, last night's video shared a lot with you. Let me give you a little update. Robbie got over there to the Texas Motor Speedway, got his little old trailer picked up, weighed out, ready to go, and got out of town. Headed for Bristol, Tennessee with that NASCAR trailer. Winning. Until the check engine light come on. Dealing with some after treatment business right there. That's the way it is with those 2012 Freightliners. They're just notorious, man. And we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. You know, the bridge that we're going to have to cross over there. Earlier in the morning and throughout the day, I've been dealing with Miss Peggy. Her Acadia started overheating, so she took it to the GM house, and sure enough, she needed a new radiator. About $1,200 worth of new radiator. It must be a solid gold-plated radiator. Yeah. I just see money flying out. Just right out of my pocket. Just anyway, then I get over here because, you know, I got going. Got my little old delivery done over here to Comfort International, I guess is what they call themselves. And, you know, I thought that this was like pillows or mattresses or something. I don't know what gave me that idea. And apparently they do mattresses across the street. That's part of their business, too. But what I brought up here was aero conditioners. I had no idea. 30,000 pounds of aero conditioners. Well, that's all right. So, that's the trailer that I dropped off behind me right there. That was that little troublesome trailer getting out of Laredo and whatnot. And at the gate, when I checked in, everything was going smooth, even though my day's been kind of bumpy. Bumpy. I'm not going to be negative at all. It's just been a bumpy day. They tell me there are no empties here. Remember, I just got through reminding you about a time back, I don't know, somewhere around Christmassy time, somewhere back in there, November, December, somewhere in there. Yeah, I think it was, late November, I think, right before Thanksgiving. I was over here in Middle Tennessee. I had to bring a Black Friday trailer over here and drop it off in Mount Juliet. And for a couple of days, they just bounced me around this area looking for an empty trailer. You remember that? Mm-hmm. They sent me down here looking for an empty trailer. Bobtail down here, they didn't have any. Went back up, looked in a couple other places, and then they sent me back like the next day or what have you. And there was an empty trailer, by golly. So, right now you might be asking yourself, well, what are you going to do? Well, of course I communicate. That's what you do. You get on the little old squawk box right there and you make things known. And the message I got back was, I don't show a load on you. What's your PTA? When you're going to be ready, PTA? No. Let's don't do that. Let's don't add some bumps to old James's day. Let's figure this out. And that's my life. Other people would go postal. Me, it's just another day. This is what happens. This is what happens to me. Back in the day, we used to call us poo-poo magnets. Mm-hmm. But I'm not a poo-poo magnet anymore. Things are going to happen. They're challenges. You got to surmount those challenges. So here's your golden nugget for the day. Dun, dun, dun. Golden nugget for the day. Because I was just speaking with Greg over in dispatch there at Lone Star. And he said I needed to quit truck driving and become a motivational speaker. And that was already in the plans, already in the works. I was going to figure out a way to make that happen. Do a little circuit. And here's your motivational, I don't know what you call it, a message for the day. We're going to leave spirituality out of it for just a second. And then we're going to throw the spirituality in there. Here's your message for the day. Things are going to happen. And they're gonna start stacking up sometimes. And it's going to be insurmountable. Insurmountable. I think that's how that word goes. It's going to seem like, oh dang, oh man. Remember, there's people out there, they get one little problem in their life and they just lose it. Depression sets in, crazy stuff can happen to you. I don't have those kind of days. Mine stack. I don't get one problem that I can just handle, or at least I don't remember them. They just come and go. It's what I taught every student that's ever put their butt in one of these seats. It looks like it's more than you can handle. Your brain's going to lock up if you do that. You got to breathe in real deep, about 10 times. Take those deep breaths so you can get some oxygen to your brain and help start clearing out all that road blockage that's going on. And then work the problem. One problem at a time. Doesn't matter which problem you choose. Work one problem at a time. My preference is to work the problem that has the highest priority that needs to be taken care of first. So that's what you put your mind to thinking. Which one of these problems am I going to solve first? Well, in this case, truck, check engine light. It's not a stop engine light, it's a check engine light. So we check the diagnostics. While he's rolling down the road, the ELD went in and checked the diagnostics, found the codes, and it's after treatment. It's a couple of codes. They're open right now. Keep driving, and hopefully it'll work itself out. It's what you do with that particular problem. As a rule, I mean, you can pull right over and you can go right into a service shop, and they'll tell you what those codes are. He just did a regen, so particulate filter is getting clogged up, you know. So hopefully by him running down the road with this heavy load that he's got, because that's a heavy trailer he's pulling, he's about 78,000 pounds, hopefully it'll blow it out. There's a little doser problem too, so that's probably going to sideline us. We're probably going to have to put it in the shop, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Miss Peggy needs a radiator for a car. They've ordered it. It should be ready Thursday. We'll take care of that Thursday. We'll cross that bridge Thursday. This is Monday, not Thursday. Attack the problems as they come to you in the order of priority. We'll attack that dude. Down the road, we'll attack that dude. It's going to be okay. We're going to work through it no matter what. Well, she's going to need a rental car. She got to go to work, got to take them kids back and forth to baseball practice and Cub Scouts and all that. I'm going to get a rental car. What's the problem? Go get it. Get in it. Go do what you do. So, you see, you hit it like that. Wasn't that big, was it? That's why I'm cool. Because ain't nothing but a thing. It's all small stuff, and you don't sweat the small stuff, you know? Another thing, we'll get spirituality into this. I know for a fact that God ain't going to give me anything I can't handle. So knowing that going in, I know I can handle it, whatever it is. I may not have the answer right away. I may even have to call somebody, help me find the answer. But at the end of the day, I got the answer, because they ain't going to give me more than I can handle. So, you know, there it is. No matter where you go, there you are. How about that? Yeah. And here I sit in the sun. It's nice and cool, but it's kind of warm in that sun. But, you know, I don't mind. Because, you know, the sun is shining on my face and not on my tombstone. It could be shining on my tombstone. I could be 6 foot under instead of 6 foot above. There ain't nothing you can't handle if you put your mind to it. And if you run across something you can't handle, there's somebody out there that can help you. They can handle it. They can help you and give you good advice. Call two or three of them. What does it hurt? Take a little advice. So I'm going to sit here. I'm going to wait on them to answer me. I'm in the sleeper, as you can tell. No problem. We got this. Right now, I got 2,258 miles on this check. That's almost a full check. I would love to have turned and burned right here. Putting, you know, another 400, 500, 600 on that check. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Maybe they'll dispatch me to go look for an empty and I'll start tacking on miles. Just like that. You know what I mean? We'll run that up a little bit. It'll be alright. It's all gonna be okay. And that's my message to you. There's your golden nugget for the day. That's how you do this. Don't let it overwhelm you. You don't need to call people to come rescue you. Rescue yourself. Make it happen. Alright? Y'all know what to do. Like it. Share it. Subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Hit that little bell over there. Let you know whenever these number one videos come out. We got a comment section below so we can share ideas, thoughts, questions, comments, concerns, whatever. But most important, remember when you're putting a comment down there, everybody in the world, on this planet, Earth, can see your comment. Think about it before you do the typing, okay? Just a little word of advice. And we'll see you down the road.